Okay, thank you very much for inviting me. I will not speak about billions of euros and about changing the orbit of a planet or stuff like that. I will speak about the thing which surrounds me. And actually, why I decided to speak about that, because I'm living 10 years in Estonia in a row. 5 years I was working in our embassy. 5 years I'm the father of Theo. And actually, what you see in front of you, this actually was the logo, unofficial logo of our embassy, and which works quite well during 5 years, much better than the official logo of the embassy. It's just, two beautiful countries shaking their hands. And I'm trying to do it till now. But I will concentrate my presentation about two interesting topics. Number one is this bottom-up approach. Why is needed? Why we are lacking it in Moldova, actually? And the second one is this feeling of ownership. Why it's so important to have this feeling that everything what is around you, your municipality, your region, your country, actually is yours. But first of all, you see a beautiful picture here. And actually, my presentation, it's a line of beautiful pictures, I think. Some of them made by myself. One of them it's made today in the morning. But actually, these four issues, which you could see here, it's actually showing quite exactly, from my perspective, four national sports in Moldova. Number one, that everything is contaminated by politics. So it doesn't matter what you're doing. This should be some politics there. And just remember what happens yesterday in mass media. And actually, today I didn't have enough time to see, but everything is politics. It could be just a forest, but it's also politics. Number two, we are overcomplicated things. Always we're trying to find the most complicated way. Number four, as my good friend is saying, that we are a paradise for complainers. We are complaining a lot. So someone is responsible. This is number four. So not me, but someone is his responsibility. And things are not working because of someone, not because of me. And here, this is the topic of my presentation. So top down or bottom up? What is important? In Moldova, unfortunately, majority of the people, they think that things should work like in the left, like top down. Someone, super clever guy somewhere, should think about you and decide what you should do for that. In some countries like Estonia, the mainstream is this bottom-up approach. So it's a large discussion about all the topics, and in the discussion, in chat, it's a co-decision, and in the end, we have a product. So what is the difference between the two? We'll try to discuss now, but the people are the same, actually, in Estonia and Moldova. And actually, they are looking for the same things, basic stuff like kindergarten, schools, nice, clean streets, and stuff like that. And next one, it's about the ownership. Actually, this is the picture which I made today in the morning. And as maybe Artur, you have seen, I'm putting this morning in my village, in our village, in our forest, and stuff like that. And actually, I'm doing this intentionally, because I'm always trying to see everything what is around me, even if I'm in Moldova or in Germany or somewhere. This is mine, because if it's mine, I'm taking care about that. Next picture, you see, it's actually not about this Kiss super band and rock stars, not even about Leonardo DiCaprio kissing this beautiful lady on the Titanic, but actually it's this principle, which we do not have in Moldova, unfortunately. Kiss, it's like keep it simple and short. Like, don't overcomplicate things. Make all stuff simple and understandable for everyone, because otherwise no one will understand what actually you are planning to do. So my next pictures, I promised you it will be just nice, beautiful pictures. Actually, it's where we live. In the left is the forest, some 200 meters from our house. And right, it's our river, which I could see right here, like 30 meters from my window. And as you could see, it's very beautiful. It's very nice. It's everyone commenting on my picture in Facebook say, "Wow, it's such a nice, beautiful place. You live like in a small paradise, in a sanatorium, stuff like that." What people cannot see is this one. Actually, we are organizing, and actually I'm organizing this story to say that, not very modest, but even living here with my neighbors, we're organizing this event every single year. And this beautiful river, which you've just seen with my son there, actually we are cleaning it. Because I took personal, in the way, personal responsibility to clean some 500 meters of this river, which is going some 200 meters there near the beach. It's entering into the sea. So actually, I think that this, I don't know, I just decided this is my, you know, place of responsibility. Actually, this is the picture made by me a few years ago, where the kids are just 200 meters from us. They are cleaning the beach because some people just throw some garbage there. But this is not only cleaning. We are meeting our neighbors. You see my wife somewhere there. It's my son. This is some Cabernet Sauvignon here, because this is this feeling of unity, feeling of ownership. This is ours. And actually, we would like to take care about that. Actually, you see our kids here, because we are doing this all together with our kids. I think this is so important. And actually, I was in Moldova like last year with my kid, and we like found a hole in asphalt somewhere in one street. And you know what my 4 year son told us? You know, father, this mayor should be in the jail because he's not fulfilling his responsibilities. So a 4 years boy already knows what a mayor should do. And if it's not making his duty, actually, this is not his place. And actually, this picture which you see here, and I'm coming slowly to what I would like to say about this bottom up. This is from a very small municipality. It's like 4,000 people, Igeva, in southern part of Estonia. But the lecture which Estonia is teaching to us, this is like my lifetime experiment, trying to understand what is the difference between the most successful post, let's say, Soviet Republic and countries like Moldova or Ukraine, for example. So lecture number one, never alone. So try to find your friends. If two people or more than two people in Estonia, they have the same interest, they will always create a NGO or a society, stuff like that. And actually, maybe you have seen Artur, but I'm also quite often writing that civil society starts with you. This is not an NGO, this is not a think tank. This is you, first of all. Never alone, this is Estonia, what they are doing. This is in a small municipality. This is in a bigger municipality. This is a dance festival when, I don't know, some 15,000 people dance together. But even here, you see, it's the people together, 10% of the population of Estonia gathered together once in 5 years to show how united they are. So never alone. This is the first lecture which Estonians learn. And this is like a red line. You know, they have friends, they have good neighbors, they have good partners. And you have your friends just in the apartment, just near you. But in every Estonian village where you will go, the first sign of a united community is this, Kiik, it's called in Estonia. So this is perfect idea to show that people are together. People build something, and actually they are building, not the municipality. The people are doing, are building together to have a perfect place where to meet, where to share time with their friends and relatives and stuff like that. But actually, they even developed a national sport. It's called kicking. So now they would like to also introduce in some, some international games and championships. And actually, the world records, actually, this is the picture made by me also just near our house, not far away here, a few hundred meters. Yes. So next one, it's a picture from Moldova. You know, I have a good friend, Mihai. He actually have seen some stories like this in Estonia. He built in his native village two benches. You see a place for garbage here and a flag. And actually, you don't know, but this flag I installed with him last year. This is the sixth flag, which local people tried to remove. And actually, we are putting once and once and once. This is the sixth flag, and we will put if it will be hundredth time. Luckily, after some 4 years, this flag is already the second year it's staying still there. So the idea is that we should try to keep, if we'd like to do some good things, let's keep doing. Because, you know, in every country, it's a lot of bad people with the bad behavior. But actually, the number of the people who are good intentioned, this is the most important thing, and this is exactly this bottom-up approach, what I'm trying to tell to you. Estonia, you know, the kids in Estonia, they have the best results in Europe already for 4 years in a row, and actually it's the only digital nation in the world. We are doing everything online, 99%. I will not stop here because it's, you know, we could discuss about in weeks about that. But one important issue, for example, in education, is that there is no IT curricula, for example. Once again, in the most developed digital nation, is not IT curricula in the school, but every school, every institution, including my university, we are choosing what to teach because we understand better than someone in the ministry. But what is important is that the ministry have this clear priority. IT is a clear priority. And an answer to this PISA test, you should know that the best answer to the question, which kindergarten or school is the best in the world or in Estonia, the answer now is clear. It's that one which is near your house. So this PISA results are the same, doesn't matter this is Tallinn or this is a village in the southern part of Estonia. This is so important. But actually how this was created? You see, some 25 years ago, this Kodukant, this is the NGOs connected in the small villages, but actually they knew that it's such a project which is called LEADER, this local action group, which now is 100 millions of euros in Estonia, which it spent to this local governmental organization in the regions. They knew 25 years ago that they should unite because somewhere in the future they will get the funds from the European Commission, from the Common Agricultural Fund, and number two, they will keep their municipalities better and cleaner. But actually what is missing in Moldova, and this is a big problem, we do not have connection between money, public money, and people, us as citizens, and people who are dealing with this money. Actually, we're not criticizing enough the people who are actually managing this money. Actually, we don't follow the electoral platform. Actually, we are electing some people who are still corrupt, still are not efficient and effective in the new position. So I think this is something which we should improve. Next one, it's about simple things. For example, this is Tartu City, and motto of Tartu City is the city of good thoughts. Something very simple, but actually attracted a lot of people. You see here in Rakvere, very simple municipality, something like Krivulen in Moldova, 15,000 people living there, but actually they attracted world attention because of one people, just one guy, and this is actually the artist of the city, and he was allowed, just make your Christmas tree as you wish, according with your vision, we will not interfere. He created these two, actually it's more, but just two of them, it's Tutser, good friend, it's a good friend of mine actually, but actually he attracted tens of thousands of people just to see, and it's all Guinness Book of Records, this Christmas trees now. Another example, it's one island, it's called like Women Island, and actually they built an example how to attract people. Now all old media is attracted by this island. Not, it's not far away here, Kihnu in Estonia. They say that it's ruled by women. Of course, it's not ruled by women, but actually as a story works perfectly. Another example actually started last year. You know, in Estonia, when it's autumn, it's a lot of apples, like in Moldova. And it was this nice, beautiful idea to put some apples on the fence, and people who does not have apples, they could select something. But actually last year, this idea came to this kind of project where producers or owners of the apple trees, together with the ports and some companies, distributed apples to every school or every medical center or in the parks, so everyone will have the possibility to enjoy them. It's like apple station. Another one already is this participatory budgeting. And I don't know why in Moldova people are not using this. Why people are not asking, you know, this is the how you could actually use some money of the municipality to be spent, decided by the citizen. Another one, Artur, you know about these reflectors. So this reflector, which is saving a lot of lives. So from 470 people who died in the first year after the regaining independence of Estonia, now it's less than 60 people who are dying every year. And actually it's because of this including one of example, good example in Moldova is to follow the good the good examples. You know, this is maybe, you know, this is Ecorazin. Just please go to them. Ask Sergio, the manager of this NGO, what they're doing, because I know they are working already for years, but nobody's repeating their example. Another example, which you could see in Moldovan village already, you see this is in Romania, but actually this is a copy-paste of one initiative. It's called Neighborhood Watch. Neighborhood Watch is, it's meaning that I will look and I will try to understand what is happening around me, and I have some protocol how to act, and I have the contacts with the policemen and with the city municipality and stuff like that. So we are trying to make our neighborhood safer for our kids. Maybe, Artur, this is a good idea for you. Is this a work, go work a bit program? So there are people who would like to offer work, and there are people who will need some work. So you could actually include here, I need, you know, someone to work 2 hours for this particular company, and this application will give you already the contract, and everything will be already done there, and vice versa. Maybe in Moldova, I think it's a good idea to make this kind of project. What you see here in front of you, actually, I don't know if you'll guess, but actually this is plenty of them in Moldovan village. This is the transformation, you know, grid station, this transformator, yes? But actually, it's the middle of Estonian village, and actually local kids decided to make it in this way. And now it's actually beautiful, and it's attracting a lot of people. Or for example, this example. Southern Estonia was a not so visited part of Estonia, let's say like that. And actually one NGO, one group of people, friends of mine actually, by the way, actually they installed this kind of National Geographic frames all Southern Estonia on the most beautiful places. And you cannot imagine how many people just came to see where these particular frames are located. This is my kid actually, 200 kilometers from here. Actually, it was such an amazing project. Now Ireland is buying this idea from Estonian company. Actually, another good idea, this is festival. We have hundreds of festivals in Moldova, but we do not have this kind of festival. This is the Opinion Festival. And it's a platform where everyone could come and say what they think about one topic or another topic or the third topic. They could participate, they could start a discussion and stuff like that. So this, another one, this is the application, it's called Anna Teada. So you could enter here, your phone will understand where you are, and will send the problem, which will make a photo directly to the municipality. And actually, this is an agreement between the developers and municipality that they will solve this problem. Another examples here, every year we are going with our family in the forest to cut our Christmas tree, actually. And actually, based on application, we are going together with our families, like a fairy tale, we are going there, or in the, and everything is by phone. On the right side, actually, I could apply for my fishing permit just in 5 seconds, I think, from my phone. This is the library of my son, because we are not living in the city center, but this library on the bus base, it's coming every Wednesday near the kindergarten of my kid, and he's selecting the books and stuff like that. It's another good idea, very simple one. What about actually this one? Because, you know, it's a lot of younger people who would like to get some knowledge from the older people, and older people need this energy from the younger people. The same like Go Work a Bit, but actually a platform where older people are meeting younger people, and they will try to have some common interests. Or this beautiful idea to promote good people. This is a friend of mine from Southern Estonia, Russian speaking, by the way. In the Southern Estonia, where it's dominated by Estonia, but actually she's a star there. So don't stop to promote good people. Another issue here is, you know, in Moldova, we are a little bit ashamed to knock the doors, to ask for help, or to take a small risk. But I will give you just 2 examples from my activity in them. I will finish now, Artur, in short time. Knock the doors. In 2010, for example, when I came here, it was 0 municipalities from Estonia cooperating with 0 municipalities from Moldova. And in 5 years, actually, it was 11 of them. 11 municipalities and regions from Moldova and Estonia. And this is a lot. And actually, this is what I really value. It's not actually the good relations between the ministers, because ministers are going and coming, but people are remaining. And I'm so proud of that. Or another one about taking a little bit of risk. Our embassy, Embassy of Moldova to Estonia, was the first embassy in the world which signed digitally the documents with the country of residence. Actually, based on the e-residence, which I know Arturio have also, we established the first digital working embassy in the world. But actually, it was not so easy because my bosses at that time, they didn't knew about that. So I took the responsibility and a little bit of risk for that. I think that's important. And you know about this. You know already that let's do it. It's come from Estonia. And actually, you could see here on the map how many points in Estonia this action has. I will finish here because I have just 30 seconds. Build the bridges. Don't be afraid of that. What you see here, actually, this is Estonian pictures made by me near my house and in Estonia. But actually, they are on the second level in Kriuli Regional Council. Actually, I opened the exhibition there. And another exhibition like this is like 50 pieces there in my homeschool in my village, where we established a small Estonia. My office of geography, where I was learning, now is small Estonia there, with Estonian equipment, with Estonian pictures, with Estonian president there and stuff like that. Try to build bridges. Don't be afraid. The world is huge and full of opportunities. This is the last one. And actually, this is what I'm really, really caring about. This is a picture from one Moldovan village where I know the mayor. And actually, this is a small girl sitting in front of the village plan. It's in Timișlia, and actually showing every single house and with the flag of the countries where the members of this family are at this particular moment. So let's, why I'm showing you this, just like take some responsibilities by ourselves. And let's try to do everything from bottom-up approach, not only waiting that a big boss somewhere will decide for you. Thank you very much.